Okay, today we're going to make some pizza dough. We're going to have pizza for supper. So what we're starting out with is a cup of beer. And you can use pretty much any kind of beer that you want. We're using an India Pale Ale because that's what we like. But you can use anything you want. You want this close to room temperature or even slightly warmer. If you're taking the beer fresh out of the fridge, what I do is I throw it in the microwave for a minute. And that gets it warm enough. So you have a tablespoon of beer. We're gonna add 2 tablespoons of olive oil, 1 tablespoon of sugar, and 1 teaspoon of salt. And we're gonna add 2 1/4 teaspoons of yeast. And then we'll add the flour. I like to get the yeast and everything in there first. And the basic recipe doesn't call for adding any spices, but I like to. It's just my personal preference. And I probably don't even add 1/2 teaspoon of anything, except for maybe 1/2 teaspoon of garlic. But I add a little bit of parsley, a little oregano, garlic powder, a little onion powder, and a little bit of basil to the basic dough, just for a little added flavor. So now we got the cup of beer in there, 2 tablespoons of olive oil, 1 tablespoon of sugar, 1 teaspoon of salt, and then the spices, which you can add it whether or not you want. And we're gonna start adding in the flour. Okay, now we've got 2 cups of regular all-purpose flour in there and 3/4 cup of a semolina flour. Today's the first time we've tried using the semolina flour. I was reading online where they say it adds a lot to the pizza crust, so we're going to try it. But you can just use 2 3/4 cups of regular all-purpose flour if you want. And you're just going to let this knead in. Not much. As always, you want to check the consistency of your dough. You want it to be just a little sticky. You don't want it to stick to your fingers. This is just a little wet, which is surprising as wet as it is outside, that I added just under 1 tablespoon and added a little at a time and see how it does. Okay, after it's all kneaded into a nice ball, just take it out and kind of flatten it out a little bit. You're going to put it into a grease bowl to let it rise. I put it into the bowl and then flip it over so that the grease sizes up. Cover it with a piece of plastic wrap over the top of the bowl and a towel. Let it rise. It's going to take about an hour to, you want it almost doubled in size. And depending on how warm it is in your kitchen, it can take an hour or longer. Well, it's about doubled now. This is about what you want. We're going to punch it down. And you're going to let it sit for a few minutes, just to rest. It makes it spread out easier. It's easier to shape it, so, and then we'll put it on our pizza pan. Okay, we've let it relax a few minutes. I've kneaded it just a little bit to get some of the air bubbles out. Shape it into a ball. Put it on your pizza pan, and then you're just going to kind of shape it out. You can make it whatever size and whatever thickness you want it to be. Just kind of spread it out. I like to build the edges up a little bit. It holds the sauce a little better. You're going to let this rise after you've got it shaped. How long is up to you. It depends on how thick you like your pizza. If you like it thin, you can bake it right away. And we're going to let this sit a few minutes. We like a little thicker crust, so ours will rise for a little bit. Just try to even it out as much as you can so it's not thick in one spot and thin in the other. And now the crust has risen enough for us, so we're going to put it in the oven. We're going to pre-bake the plain crust at 400 for 8 minutes. You just want it to start lightly getting brown. It gives it a chance to just cook through a little bit, and it gives you a nicer finished product. So before you throw anything on, we'll throw that in the oven and set the timer for 8 minutes. And then we'll take it out and add all the toppings. We're gonna add a little of our homemade pasta sauce and some mushrooms and some ham and a few other little goodies to it. Well, now it's baked for 8 minutes. So we're gonna add the sauce. You can use whatever you like for your pizza sauce. We're using our homemade tomato sauce. And of course you can use whatever you want for toppings. Just spread it on as thick as you like or as thin. Layer of mozzarella. To start with, and then we're going to add some chopped ham. Just a little.
Meat lovers.
And we're gonna add a little cooked hamburger. This is actually some leftover from tacos, so it's seasoned. Some mushrooms. I cooked the mushrooms a little bit, or I should say, he cooked the mushrooms a little bit, because this doesn't really bake long enough to cook everything, so you want to make sure your toppings are somewhat cooked to start with, unless you like them half raw.
Fungus.
Fungus.
Max.
We've got the dog standing there drooling. I'm going to put a little Parmesan over it. And we'll put some more mozzarella. Lots of cheese. And then we'll put the pepperoni on top. Reduce the heat to 375, and this is going to take anywhere from 15 to 18 minutes to bake, depending on how brown you like your crust. And you want to make sure that your center's hot and the cheese is all melted. And then I like to sprinkle a little, well, there's one for the dog. I like to sprinkle a little more Parmesan over the top. Helps make the pepperoni crispy. And in the oven it goes. Minutes exactly. Looks good, smells awesome.
Crushed red pepper.
Yeah. Implements of destruction. Oh yeah. Where's the red pepper?
Look.
Crushed red pepper.